Welcome, students. Hope you're all doing good. So let us just recall what we learned in the previous class. So we looked into the international number system and the usage of commas in Indian and international number system and comparison of both Indian and international number system. So before we move on to today's class, I have two examples for you students from which you'll come to know what we are going to learn in today's class. So the examples are: when we have two objects with different quantities, one is more in quantity while the other one is less. So look at these boxes of sweets. The first box has more number of sweets while the second one is less. Similarly, look at these plates of cookies. The red plate has more number of cookies while the blue plate has less number of cookies. Now look at these birds sitting on the trees. The long branch on the left has more number of birds while the short branch on the right has less number of birds. So students, from these examples, do you have any idea about what we are going to learn today? Yes, it's about comparison of numbers. So in comparison of numbers, we'll be learning about comparing numbers with unequal number of digits and comparing numbers with equal number of digits. Before we move on to these, we look into the signs used to compare numbers. So the first one is the equal sign. So when is equal sign used? When two numbers are equal, we use the equal sign. For example, could you see 2 is equal to 2? So two numbers are equal. So when two numbers are equal, we use the equal to sign. So the next one is the less than sign. So when is the less than sign used? When one value is smaller than the other, we use a less than sign. Okay. So for example, could you see the two numbers 3 and 5? So 3 is smaller than 5, right? So we represent the less than sign by that. Okay. So generally, the small end always points to the smaller number. Like, could you see the 3 is the smaller number? So the smaller end of the sign points to the smaller number, that is 3. So we represent the less than symbol like that. So the smaller end is pointed toward the smaller number. So 3 is less than 5. Okay. So the third one is the greater than symbol. When is greater than sign used? When one value is bigger than another, we use a greater than sign. For example, can you see the two numbers 9 and 6? So 9 is greater than 6, right? So the smaller end is pointed towards the smaller numbers, that is 6. So we represent the greater than sign by this sign. Okay. So these are the three signs used to compare numbers. The first one is the equal sign, the second one is the less than sign, and the third one is the greater than sign. Okay.
First, we'll move on to comparing numbers with unequal number of digits. So the rule for comparing numbers with unequal number of digits is: a number with more digits is always greater than the number with less number of digits. I repeat, a number with more digits is always greater than the number with less number of digits.
Now we look into an example. Compare the numbers 160 and 100616. So the first step you're going to do is see the number of digits. Okay, first consider the number 16090. So the number of digits in the first number is 5. So it is a 5-digit number. And consider the second number 100616. So the number of digits in the second number is 6. So you all know that a 6-digit number is greater than a 5-digit number. Okay. So lesson with unequal number of digits. Can you see? Here it is a 5-digit number and it is a 6-digit number. So unequal number of digits. So you know, you all know that 5-digit number is smaller than 6-digit number. Okay. So while writing, you are going to write it as 1,
00616 is greater than 16090. Okay, or you can also write it as 16090 is smaller than 100616. I repeat, you're going to compare these both the numbers. So the first step you're going to do is you're going to see the number of digits. Okay, so I'm going to take the first number. So the number of digits is 5, and the second number is, the number of digits is 6. So when you compare both these numbers, you already know that a 6 digit number is greater than a 5 digit number. So 1,616 is greater than 16,090. Okay, you can also write it as 16,090 is less than 1,616.
The next one is the comparing numbers with equal number of digits. The rule for comparing numbers with equal number of digits is, when the two numbers have the same number of digits, we start comparing the digits from the leftmost place until we come across unequal digits. Okay? So if two numbers have the same or the equal number of digits, the number with the bigger digit on the left hand side is always greater. And if the leftmost digits are the same, we compare the next digit to the right and keep doing this until the digits are different. Okay, I repeat, the rule for comparing numbers with equal number of digits is, when the two numbers have the same number of digits. Okay, so when two numbers have equal number of digits, we always start comparing the digits from the leftmost place until we come across unequal digits. And the next is, if two numbers have equal number of digits, the number with the bigger digit on the left hand side is always greater. And if the leftmost digits are the same, we keep comparing the next digit to the right, and we keep on doing this until the digits are different. Okay,
now we look into an example. Compare 743 and 838. So as I've already said, the first step when you compare is you're going to see the number of digits. So consider the first number 743. How many digits? It's a 3-digit number. Now consider the second number 838. It is also a 3-digit number. Can you all see that? In this problem, you are going to compare numbers with equal number of digits. Okay, here the first number is a 3-digit number, the second number is also a 3-digit number. In this case, the second step is you are going to compare the numbers from the left hand side. Okay, so this is case 2, or you can also say it as step 2. Okay, so compare the digits from the left hand side. The first number it is 7, whereas the second number it is 8. So 7 is smaller than 8, right? So you're going to write it as this. Okay, you're going to write it this way. So 7 is less than 8, so therefore 743 is less than 838, or you can also write it as 838 is greater than 743. Next, we'll move to another example. Compare 2180 and 2183. Okay, so the first step is you're going to see the number of digits. Okay, step 1, you're going to see the number of digits. So consider the first number 2180, the number of digits is 4. And consider the second number 2183, here it is also a 4-digit number. So when there is an equal number of digits, you are going to move to step 2. Okay, so what is step 2? You are going to compare numbers from the left hand side. So 2, whereas here it is also 2. Okay, so both the numbers are equal. Okay, in this case, you are going to move to the next position. So the next position in the first number is 1, whereas in the second number is also 1. Here again 1 is equal to 1. In this case we cannot derive at the conclusion. Again you are going to move to the next position. So the next position in first number is 8. Whereas in the second number is also 8. 8 is also equal to 8. And then again you are going to move to the next position, which is 0. And here it is 3. Now you can see that 0 is less than 3. Okay. 0 is less than 3. Or you can even write it as 3 is greater than 0. In this case you can see that 2183 is greater than 2180. Therefore 2183 is greater than 2180. Or you can even write it as 2180 is less than 2183. Got it, students? Now we are going to compare these both the numbers. The first step is you are going to see the number of digits. Okay, so the first number, it is a 4-digit number, and the second number is also a 4-digit number. When you are going to compare number with equal number of digits, you can't derive at a conclusion, right? Now we are going to move to the step 2. So in step 2, you are going to compare numbers from the left hand side. So the first digit in left hand side is 2, and the first digit in the second number is also 2. So 2 is equal to 2. We can't derive at a conclusion. Then you are going to move to the second position in the first number is 1. Similarly, the second number is also 1. So 1 is also 1. Again, you are going to move to the next position. It is 8, and here it is also 8. So 8 is equal to 8. Again, you are moving to the next position. It is 0 and it is 3. So from this, you can see that 0 is less than 3. Or you can even write it as 3 is greater than 0. So you can see that 2183 is greater than 2180. Or you can even write it as 2180 is less than 2183.
Next, we are going to see the comparison of two numbers using a place value chart. So the first step is you are going to see whether the number of digits in the given two numbers are equal. And the second step is you are going to compare the place values using the place value chart. So what is the first step? You are going to see whether the number of digits in the given two numbers are equal. And then you are going to compare the place values using the place value chart.
I am going to represent the number in the place value chart. You have already learned this. This is a Indian system place value chart. Okay. I am going to represent the first number. Okay. So 6, 4, 7, 3, 8, 2, 9, 5. Similarly, I am going to write the second number. 8, 4, 7, 3, 8, 2, 9, 5. Okay. Now you are going to compare the digits of the two numbers from the highest place value. Okay. While comparing, you are going to come from the left hand side. So in the crores place, can you see 5 is equal to 5. Okay. You can't derive at the conclusion, you are going to the next position. Similarly here, 9 is equal to 9. Again, you can't come at the conclusion, you are going to move to the next position. Similarly, 2 is equal to 2. 8 is equal to 8. Going to the next position, 3 is equal to 3. 7 is equal to 7. And 4 is equal to 4. And again, you are going to move to the next position. You can see that 6 is less than 8. Or you can write it as 8 is greater than 6. Therefore, the number 5, 9, 2, 8, 3, 7, 4, 8 is greater than 5, 9, 2, 8, 3, 7, 4, 6. Okay. Or you can even write it as 5, 9, 2, 8, 3, 7, 4, 6 is less than 5, 9, 2, 8, 3, 7, 4, 8. Got it, students?
So next we'll move on to another topic. So here's two examples for you students from which you will come to know what we are going to learn in the next topic. Okay? So the examples are, let us meet Rahul. Okay? He has to climb 10 steps which are numbered from 1 to 10. So Rahul starts from step number 1, then climbs on to step number 2, then to step number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and finally to step number 10. So here's our friend Rahul again is on step number 10 as to come down to step number 1. So he comes down to step number 9, which brings him to a lower level than step number 10. Then to step number 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and finally to step number 1. So students, from these examples, do you have any idea about what we are going to learn next? It's about the ascending and descending order. What is ascending order? Ascending order is a sorting method in which the sort starts from the lowest to the highest, or the smallest value to the largest value. Okay, it means the smallest or the earliest value in the order that will come at the top of the list. It is denoted by the symbol. Okay, can you see that symbol? It is denoted by that symbol. So what is ascending order? It is a sorting method, and you're going to list the numbers from the lowest or the smallest value to the largest value. And the symbol for ascending order is that. Okay, so you could see this image. The numbers are arranged from smaller number to the largest number, and we call this as ascending order. In ascending order, the numbers are arranged in increasing order. Okay, students, descending order. So what is descending order? Descending order is the opposite of ascending order. Descending order is a sorting method in which the sort starts from the highest value to the lowest value, or the largest value to the smallest value. Okay, it is the opposite of ascending. In ascending, we saw that the numbers are arranged from the lowest or the smallest value to the highest value, and in descending, the numbers are arranged from the highest value to the lowest value. Okay, so for a given set of numbers, the highest valued number is written first in descending order, and the lowest valued numbers are written at the last. So in descending order, the numbers are arranged from the highest value to the lowest value, and it is denoted by that symbol. Okay, could you see the image? The numbers are arranged from the largest to the smallest. That is, the numbers are arranged in decreasing order from 4, 3, 2, 1. So the numbers are arranged in decreasing order. Whereas in ascending order, the numbers are arranged in increasing order. Got it, students?
Now, we look into an example. You're going to arrange the numbers 9, 8, 5, 5, 8, 5, 3, 5, 5 in ascending and descending order. Just now you have learned that ascending order means you're going to arrange the numbers from smallest to the largest, while descending order means you're going to arrange the numbers from largest to the smallest. Okay, now consider the numbers 9, 8, 5, 5, 8, 5, 3, 5, 5, 1, 4, 5, 8, 6, 5. Okay, so see the number of digits. So the number of digits in the first number is 3. Here it is also 3. Here it is also 3. Here it is 4 and here it is 4. You know that a 3-digit number is less than a 4-digit number. Okay, so first compare these 3 digits first. Okay, so the next step, when you have equal number of digits, what is the next step that you do? You're going to compare the numbers from the left hand side, right? See here, the first number here it is 9, here it is 5, whereas here it is 3. So 3 is smaller than 5. Okay, so first comes the 355 number. So this will be the ascending order. First comes the 355. Next, 5 is less than 9, right? Next comes the 585 and then 985. Next, you're going to move to the 4-digit number. See the first number? It is equal. 1 is equal to equal. Move to the next position. 2. And here it is 8. You know that 8 is greater than 2, right? 2 is less than 8. So, since ascending order is arranging the numbers from the smallest to the largest. So, you're going to write the number 1245 and then the number 1865. Students, can you get it? While coming to ascending order, you are going to arrange the numbers from the smallest to the largest. So, consider these numbers. The first three numbers have 3-digit value, whereas the fourth and the fifth number as a 4-digit number. Okay? So, when numbers have equal number of digits, what do you do? You are going to compare the numbers from the left hand side. So, I am going to compare. First, I am going to take the 3-digit numbers and I am going to compare the first digit. Okay? First place of these numbers. So here it is 9, here it is 5 and 3. So 3 is the smallest when compared to 5 and 9. So I am going to write the number 355 followed by 585 and then the 985. Okay, next I am moving to the 4 digit number. I am going to see the first place. 1 is equal to 1. I can't derive at the conclusion. Again I am going to move to the next position. 2 and here it is 8. So 2 is less than 8, right? I am going to write 1245 less than 1865. Okay. Next is the descending order. Descending order means you are going to arrange the numbers from the largest value to the smallest value. That is, it is the opposite of ascending order. So, write the largest number first. 1865 is greater than 1245. Is greater than 985. 985 is greater than 585 and 585 is greater than 355. That's it, students.
So that's it for today's class. Now let us just do a small recap of what we learned today.
So we saw comparison of numbers. In comparison of numbers, we saw how to compare numbers with unequal number of digits and how to compare numbers with equal number of digits. Next, we saw the signs used to compare numbers. So, when is equal sign used? When two numbers are equal, we use the equal sign. And when is the less than sign used? When one value is smaller than another, we use the less than sign. And when is greater than sign used? When one value is bigger than the another value, we use the greater than sign. And next, we moved on to how to compare numbers with unequal number of digits. So, the rule is a number with more digits is always greater than the number with less number of digits. And then we moved on to the problems related to comparing numbers with unequal number of digits.
Moved on to comparing numbers with equal number of digits. So the rule for comparing numbers with equal number of digits is when the two numbers have same number of digits, we start comparing the digits from the leftmost place, okay, until we come across unequal digits. That is, if two numbers have equal number of digits, the numbers with the bigger digit on the left hand side is greater, and if the leftmost digits are the same, we compare the next digit to the right and keep on doing this until the digits are different. And we saw an example related to comparing numbers with equal number of digits. Then we moved on to how to compare two numbers using the place value chart. Next, we moved on to ascending and descending order. So what is an ascending order? It is a sorting method in which the sort starts from the lowest to the highest value. Okay, that is be coming in the front and the largest number will come at the end. Okay, so it is denoted by that symbol. And we saw an image which gives a clear idea about what is an ascending order. So ascending order means increasing order. You're going to arrange numbers from the smallest to the largest. And then we moved on to what is in descending order. So descending order is the opposite of ascending order, in which you're going to sort the numbers from the highest value to the lowest value, and it is represented by that symbol. Okay, and then we saw an image of what is descending order. That is, the numbers are arranged from the largest to the smallest. That is, it is a decreasing order. Okay, so descending order means it is a decreasing order. Okay, that's it, students. I have attached the worksheets for you all. Kindly solve this in your notebook. Thank you, students.